By and large, vast numbers of people are now recognizing that our contemporary science, however brilliant, is heartless and leads to nothing that's actually satisfying to the human soul. And it is Egypt, along with the other civilizations as well, the other ancient civilizations, but it's Egypt that we have access to. It's Egypt that, in going through their temples and tombs and studying their pyramids, we get a living sense of how human beings, civilized human beings, once behaved. If we look at these magnificent specimens of old kingdom art and realize that these are not just works of genius sculpture, but that they enshrine highly sophisticated metaphysical and scientific doctrine, we begin to realize that ancient Egypt is not as we have been taught, and that this doctrine could not have been developed within a couple of hundred years, and is almost certainly a legacy handed down over the generations from that still earlier civilization. Return to the source, the term Shmolid Lubitsch, translated from the Egyptian, meaning the ability or the capacity of human beings to reach that higher state of consciousness that is our origin, according to esoteric tradition, time immemorial. So return to the source has a dual meaning here, actually, because in one sense it is that philosophical and metaphysical capacity to return to divine origins, but also historically it's a return back to this earlier civilization.
Actually, very interesting where we are at the moment, because all of this crash that's engulfing the entire world now is a consequence of a fraudulent and debased materialistic philosophy. Specific role to play, which is the acquisition of a level of consciousness that we are not born with, that we have the potential to reach. And this is what in Egypt is called the doctrine of immortality, and what in other civilizations is called samadhi or nirvana or whatever, I mean, different names for it. But basically, it's the same doctrine that we're here for a reason, and if we don't pursue that path, we do so at our peril.